show everybody how to do leather tooling. Leather tooling is basically putting a picture, or putting an image or design or some sort of, you know, some sort of artwork onto your leather piece that you're doing. So what I'm going to be using today is I'm using part of the Rouqued pattern, which is basically the history chain pattern, because it has some meaning. So I'm going to be using that today, and I'm going to go over the tools real quick that we're going to use for this. Firstly, we're going to use, this is what's called a swivel knife. And the reason it's called a swivel knife is because you put your finger in the saddle here at the top, and when you cut, it swivels. You can swivel it so you can get those nice rounded kind of curved cuts if you need to. We're going to sharpen that using some jeweler's rouge and what's called a sharpening strop. So I might as well set that over there. And then we're also going to be using a rawhide mallet with our tooling stakes, or tooling punches, I should say. And the one we're going to be using primarily is going to be beveling punch. I don't think we might need the pear shader. Is it's good if you want to kind of shade around or inside, you know, like let's say you wanted to shade around here to make your design stand out. So we might use that one. We're not going to use the cedar, the viner, or the camouflage tool, which that's what's left in here. So I'm just going to set those in this for now. We're also going to need a scratch awl, which is here, which we'll use that to trace our design with. And then that's it. It's not a whole lot of tools. If you need to buy all these tools, I mean, it's not super, they're not going to be cheap. The main ones to start out with would be the swivel knife. You don't necessarily have to sharpen it after every use, although I recommend sharpening it after every use. But you definitely need your swivel knife. You need a scratch awl of some sort. And you need at least the bevel and pear shader punches, and then some sort of either a rubber mallet, vinyl mallet, or a rawhide mallet. You don't want to use a metal hammer on these punches because you will destroy them. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and sharpen up our swivel knife. And to do that, we just use some jeweler's rouge. And this is basically just an emery compound. And I'm going to just put some right here on the strop. You don't have to you don't have to like really seriously load it up. You just have to get enough on there to kind of get some white on there so you can see. You should be able to see that there's a little bit of white on there. I always like to keep this stuff in the bags because it doesn't really get all over the place, but you know, it kind of keeps it safe. Now what you do here, and be real careful with your swivel knife because you don't want to cut yourself. I'm going to move my holster here out of the way, and I'm just going to going by the edge of the swivel knife here, so I'm at the angle of the edge. So you want to make sure you're at the right angle, and then you just drag it. You turn it, and you drag it. And you turn it, and you drag it. You keep turning it, and you keep dragging it. Now, you don't have to buy a nice little strop like this. You can just use a regular piece of leather if you want to. The main thing is keeping it at the right angle and turning it each time you drag it across the strop. I have not sharpened mine up in some time. So what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to use the rougher side here, or the more coarse side of the sharpening strop. Kind of get a little bit better edge here. And this is basically like if you were to sharpen a straight razor, like an old cutthroat razor, that kind of thing. You used to see them, you know, in the cartoons or whatever, where they would slap it across a piece of leather. That's basically what you're doing. And you just want to really get it good and sharp with that jeweler's rouge. I have not sharpened mine in a while, so I can tell it. All right, so put our strop in that behind, and we'll test our sharpness real quick. Let me find a scrap piece of leather up here. I've got plenty of those. And we've got a sponge here that's a little bit damp, and we just sort of dampen the leather here. And we'll take our knife here, and oh yeah. So you can see how that made that cut. That's a very nice cut. So, all right, so we know we've got our knife sharp. We've tested it, we've sharpened it, and we've tested it. So let's go to getting this image onto our actual leather. Now, I would say make sure you get some scrap leather and really practice, okay? You want to practice with this because practice is important. And you want to make sure you know how to make the turns and all that fun stuff. So get some scrap leather, practice. It doesn't hurt anything. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I don't really want to get this pattern wet. So I'm just going to take the scratch all. And I'm going to hold this down as best as I can. I'm going to make sure that it's straight. I can move it in a bit. And I'm going to hold this down. I'm going to take my scratch all. And I'm going to very lightly trace this. Onto the leather. I'm just pushing down very, very lightly. Try to keep it on there and keep it from moving. That's always the hard part. A lot of people will just take make a tracing on a piece of paper, lay the whole paper on it, and then trace it off. I could do that too. I'm kind of doing it the hard way here. But that's okay. I've never been known to do anything easy. And then we go on the top. Now, of course, when we make this, when we make this cut with our knife, it's going to be nice and smooth. But you can see how we're transferring this image onto there. Now we just do the inner part. Alright, there we go. Now, I'm going to hold this up so you guys can see it. So we've got our first design in there. Let's go ahead and cut that in. So what I'm doing is I'm just using a, there's a lot of water in this. You don't want to get your piece of leather, like, completely laden with water. You just want to dampen it up where you're going to be doing your cutting. So I'm just going to damp it up so I get a nice kind of a nice brown color here. But I don't want to lose my image. So then I'm going to hold my knife here, and let me bring the camera down a bit. Put a little more water on this. And then we hold our swivel knife firmly, but not too firm. And then you want to kind of cut it at sort of an angle here. I'm just following . Alright, so there's the first cut. I'm going to turn it. I'll bring this down a little bit more if I can. I can, good. Now I'm going to make another cut. And then a cut here. Here. You want to make sure you get these cuts nice and joined up here. And then we'll make our inside cut here with our half diamond. The good thing is it's not that difficult to make straight lines with this swivel knife. The hardest thing is if you want to do like curvy cuts. Now put a little more water, a little bit more water there. Go back over these. It's okay if you get a little bit of a awkward cross cut there. Let me move this back up so you can see what I'm doing. That's all right. Okay, so we've got our first shape in. I'm going to dampen this up a little more here. You can see how it takes the shape. And yeah, I got a little bit of a wonky cut there, but that's all right. We'll take it out with the beveler here. So the way I'm going to do this is there's two different ways you can do it. You can bevel it from the inside or you can bevel it from the outside. I'm going to bevel it from the outside. And what you do is you move the beveling tool across the cut as you tap it. And you just tap it lightly. You don't have to tap it very hard. And you want to try to make it a nice smooth movement. Just like that. You get a nice raised area right here. Move this up a little bit, and we'll tap on this just a little bit more, and then we'll move on to another side. Again, you want to follow inside those cuts. You just put it right in the cut. And you follow it right around. And you want to watch your moisture level. When your leather looks like it's starting to turn back to its normal color, you want to hit it with a little more water. Again, not too much water, but enough to change the color. That might have been a little too much, but that's all right. The key is trying to move this beveler as smooth as possible, which is, it can be very difficult. What I usually like to do is take my pinky and kind of hold my pinky on the leather and push down. That gives me a little bit extra control. Now we've got to do the back. Or I should say the outside curve. There's also a lot of great YouTube tutorials on how to do this. Another thing, too, is they actually make a mallet specifically for this that's made out of like a hard nylon. And it's basically, I mean, it's called a tooling mallet. And it's probably a little bit better to use than this rawhide mallet, because it's a little bit springy. It's also round, so it's kind of like, it looks kind of like this water bottle. And you hold it, there's a handle down here like that, and you just kind of hold it and you hit it like that. So, you know, that might be the way you want to go. They're not cheap. I don't think they run less than, you know, $30 or $40. I don't do enough leather tooling to require using one. Again, it's all about patience, just like anything else. And I just do gentle taps. I don't do any of these crazy hard taps or anything like that. And my tooling's not the best because I don't do it often enough. But some of you might find that you really love doing this, and you know that may be something that you become really good at. This tutorial or this live stream is basically just designed to introduce it to you. And then you can decide if you actually like doing it or not. Now, on the inner diamond, I'm going to switch. I was doing the outside with the bevel this way, and I'm going to switch. Okay, and do the bevel inside on this one so that this edge here is a little more recessed on the inside. Let me turn this. One thing you always want to do too is you want to make sure that you're turning your leather piece here. Again, you don't have to hit this very hard. It's not about how hard you hit it. It's about taking your time. If you've got any areas that have kind of where you've skipped around a little bit, you can always go back over them. And all right, so we've got our shape tooled in here. And you can feel that it's definitely inset into the leather. And when we create our holster here, that shape, or once we get our holster put together, that shape is going to be kind of the primary outside shape. Now at this point, we're going to use the pear shader here, okay? And what I'm going to do is we're going to go around through here and kind of even this up a bit. So we're going to add a little bit more water to it. And again, very lightly, we're going to stick to that edge, but we're going to go just to the opposite side, okay, of this edge. We're going to go outside. And what that does is that helps, well, it pushes the leather down. It compresses the leather around here, so it helps your tooled design stick up more. You know, this is a three-dimensional, this becomes kind of a three-dimensional design when we use the pear shader. It really helps lock in that three-dimensional look. And that's all tooling really is you're putting a three-dimensional design into a piece of leather. It's not much different than, you know, than carving on a piece of wood. Now, another thing that a lot of people have when they do this too, a lot of leather craftsmen actually use a marble or a granite block when they do this. Now, I don't do that because, again, I'm not doing this often enough to warrant that. And always make sure you keep plenty of water on this. Alright, so now we've got our even more three-dimensional shape in there. So now let's say maybe we want to do like, I don't know, a little, maybe some kind of little design here. Let me get my scratch all here, and let's say we just want to do a little, kind of like a little swoosh, another swoosh, and another swoosh, something like that, something to kind of give it just another little design. So what I'm going to do, make sure you wet it down. And we'll go for a fourth. Just like that. Now what I'm going to do is, let me get my beveler back out here. Pop a little more water back down on it. Always make sure you cap up your swivel knife. And just very lightly And I'm only doing one side at a time here. And I'm doing it really lightly, because I don't want to, I want this little, kind of this little, I don't know what you call it, wing or whatever. I want those little wings to kind of show up. Water on there. Might be a little too much. There we go. Alright, and then I'm going to take my pear shader again. And you always want to give your pear shader a little bit of a smack when you're going around this. Or whatever you're going around, whatever shape it is. Because that's what pushes it down for you. That's what pushes down the outside. So if you don't give it a good whack, you're not going to get the 3D design. So that's what this holster will look like when it's all sewn together. That's going to be our shapes on it. And it'll look really neat. Now you can try to do letters. A lot of times that's easier to buy those punches, those letter punches, or, you know, kind of an alphabet punch already made. It's pretty difficult to do letters free-handed. I don't think I'd want to do it. So, yeah. I have endless mad skills, Tori. Well, I don't know about that. But I'm just trying to do my part to learn y'all up in education. But I'm not going to put anything on this side of the holster because nobody's going to really see it. And you don't tool the rough side of the holster. So, I mean, that's really about it. I could probably put some stuff in here if I wanted to. I don't like making my holsters super busy. As you can see on the holster on the other side, I've got a T-visor, kind of the old Republic style T-visor and a couple of Mando skull tusks. And on this side, I've got a Rukhed. And I don't know what those are. We'll call them Strill wings. I don't know. A Strill hand. I don't know what it is. But this is a Rukhed, part of a Rukhed. So, yeah. And that's what this holster will look similar to this one when we're done. But that is the very basics of leather tooling.